Hello everybody, this is Punk Demon Neo, previously known as Ultimate Lifeform RB, and I am finally back with a brand new playthrough featuring Mega Man 8. This game was originally released in 1997 for the Sony PlayStation and the Sega Saturn, and it is a direct sequel to Mega Man 7, which was released for the Super Nintendo in 1995. This game also was released to commemorate the 10th anniversary of the Mega Man franchise, and this will be the subject of my newest playthrough. It's been a while since I've done any new content on the channel related to a new playthrough, since I finished my playthroughs for Call of Duty 2 and Sonic Adventure DX. I've been through a bit of an awkward period of my life, in my personal life and on the channel itself, but I am finally back with a new playthrough, and I've decided to go with Mega Man 8. So here we are looking at the options screen. This is my button configuration that I will be running with for this playthrough. And as you can probably tell, I am using the PlayStation version to conduct this playthrough because I do not own the Saturn version. But in any event, enough of my yapping. We're going to go ahead and start the game. And we're going to start off with an anime cutscene, which I actually thought was kind of impressive back when I first saw this game when I was a kid. The voice acting, not so much, but the visuals are, they're pretty good for the time. But in any case, I'm gonna shut up for now and I'm gonna let the rest of the cutscene speak for itself.
You'll pay for this insult. I'll be back.
Dr. Light, what is the problem?
A strange meteor has fallen to Earth just a while ago. This meteor seems to be emitting a powerful energy signature. Something this powerful must not fall into the hands of evil.
I understand, Dr. Light. I'm on it.
Thank you, Mega Man. If you can, please bring the meteor back.
Okay.
Alright then, I don't think there's anything I can say about the voice acting that hasn't already been said many times already. The voice acting in this game is pretty infamous. But here we go, ladies and gentlemen, let's begin the gameplay of a new playthrough. Welcome to Mega Man 8 with an intro stage, and if you'll take a look at the background here real quick, you can see, I guess these are supposed to be the remains of the Mecha Dragon from Mega Man 2. Nice little continuity nod. But let's go ahead and get going. Mega Man 8, like, basically, you know, it's basically the classic Mega Man gameplay translated into a 32-bit system. This was the big leap from the 16-bit consoles to the 32-bit systems for the Mega Man franchise, at least classic Mega Man. Although I I'm pretty sure not too long after this game came out, the X series would also make the leap to the PlayStation as well. So, as we go through this intro stage, you're probably wondering, why Mega Man 8? Why am I doing Mega Man 8? Well, it's very simple. Mega Man 8 was the first Mega Man game I was ever exposed to as a kid. And I'll explain a little bit more as we go through this little bit of dialogue. You folks know how to read, I'm sure. So yes, Mega Man 8 was the first Mega Man game I saw. It was actually one of my cousins had it for the PlayStation. And the PlayStation version is the only version of Mega Man 8 I've ever played. I've never owned a Sega Saturn. I do know there is extra content in the Sega Saturn version compared to the PlayStation version, which unfortunately I will not be able to show off. But yes, this was the first Mega Man game I ever played, the first Mega Man game I ever saw, so I thought, let's give it a shot. Let me see if I can make a playthrough out of it. And if you were paying attention to that dialogue, we actually got a new weapon. It's not often we get a new weapon in the intro stage, but yes, we get the Mega Ball. Have you ever wanted to have your dream of being a soccer superstar? Well, Mega Man can accomplish that dream with the Mega Ball, which actually can be useful in certain situations. Anyway, cause that enemy to drop onto that switch and you'll actually be taken to this subterranean area. It's actually important, well not important, but there is a reason for going down here because there is actually an item that we can get down here. Actually, an item that's actually quite common in this game. It's actually a collectible. It's an item that was introduced in Mega Man 7. It's an item called a bolt, or a screw, depending on what game you're playing or whatever. And one interesting thing about this area is that this area demonstrates a new mechanic for Mega Man. According to, as far as I understand, this is the only official Mega Man game of any sort where Mega Man can actually swim. Why it took him 8 games into the franchise to gain the ability to swim, I don't know, but it works in this situation. Anyway, go up into this area. And there's our first bolt. Bolts are a finite collectible in this game. There are 40 of them in total. And basically, the idea with the bolts is that you can collect them to purchase upgrades from Roll. I will not be going for all 40 bolts, but I will, of course, try to collect as many as possible. Anyway, go down there where those platforms are descending, and you can grab another bolt in order to add to your collection. Occasionally, you'll come across those little party balls, if you will, that will drop items. Usually, they'll recover some kind of recovery item, either health energy or weapon energy. And there's another bolt right there. Every stage in the game has bolts that you can collect in order to add to your total. And just like that, we're back out in the overworld. Now, there's really not much that we missed. If we try to go backwards, there's really not much that we missed out here up in the overworld portion. But, you know, we can go back and kill some extra enemies. We can take out the Mi Tools. It's not a Mega Man game without Mi Tools, is it? One of the iconic enemies of classic Mega Man and the franchise in general. And I forgot to reconfigure my controls before recording this. I meant to map the Mega Buster to the square button, not the triangle button, so it's kind of awkward trying to charge the Mega Buster right now while also pressing the X button to jump. And I'm not doing a good job avoiding damage right about now towards the end. So yes, Mega Man does have his classic Mega Buster, which he can charge. He also has his sliding ability. And if we go a little bit further, we'll come across the boss of the opening stage, right about here. Looks pretty innocuous, but it's a robot! What's better than a giant enemy crab? A giant enemy robot crab! Okay, so this guy's really not that difficult, especially if you come at him with the, with your special weapon. Basically, just use the Mega Ball, it'll expose his inner workings, and then you can just spam the Mega Ball until he dies. Just gotta make sure you got the correct angle, though. He'll also try to trap you with his pincers, as he's doing right now. I swear I'm not intentionally taking damage here, I'm actually not doing very well. Recorder's curse. Please die. He's not as hard as I made him look. He is definitely not difficult at all. It's been a while since I've recorded something, folks. Cut me some slack. But of course, we have to have a run-in with good old Dr. Wily. Dr. Wily, why are you here?
Mega Man, so you've come. How did you find my secret base?
I'm impressed.
But you're too late. I've just found something that's more powerful than this base. Ha 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 ha!
Now the world is mine! Gotcha!
Trust me, I think you'd rather hear me voice act than the actual voice actors. Wait, Wily! I've got to go after him! Then why don't you? What's this? A robot? It's still alive! I must help it! Yeah, I'm not even gonna try to read the rest of this, because I'm so tempted to do it in the actual voice Dr. Light is given, and yeah. So it seems that we have a robot here, and of course, Mega Man, being the altruistic machine that he is, wants to help him out. And apparently, Dr. Wily obviously has something nefarious going on here.
I got it, Doctor!
Sonic has Dr. Eggman, and Mega Man has Dr. Wily. It's always gotta be evil scientists. What's up with that? Anyway, at the end of every stage, you're given the opportunity to save your progress. Using your memory cards, or using, like, the memory card feature, because this is actually being recorded on the PlayStation 3, not an actual original PlayStation. Because my original PlayStation has seen better days. Showing its age. But yes, we've saved our game, and now at this point we are done with the opening stage, and we will be taken to, you know it's coming, the classic stage selection, which has gotten a bit of a facelift with the leap to 32-bit. And as you can see, we only have four Robot Masters to choose from, unlike the earlier entries in the classic Mega Man franchise, which actually is a holdover from Mega Man 7. We only have four Mega Man Robot Masters to choose from initially. Once we beat these four, the other four will be available, and then, you know, the full eight will be available to defeat. But before we get into that, we can visit Dr. Light's home base, where we can... First, we can meet Roll, who in this game, it's a bit of a meme, her voice is actually more masculine than Mega Man's in this game. But anyway, with Roll here, this is primarily the reason you want to try to collect the bolts, because talking to Roll, when you collect enough bolts, you can actually purchase parts. These parts basically function as upgrades. You can get a power shield that will remove knockback when you get hit. You can spawn with extra lives. You can modify your charge shot. You can use an item that will allocate energy to a weapon, and for some reason you can also get an upgrade that allows you to climb ladders faster. Don't know what's up with that. And you can also use an upgrade that will allow you to exit a stage after defeating a Robot Master if you decide to revisit a stage or something. Unfortunately, we don't have enough bolts to buy any upgrades at the moment. You can also save your progress from here. You can go back into the options. Let me go ahead and reconfigure my controls the way they're supposed to be.
Good luck, Mega Man!
And that's it for Dr. Light's lab. But in any event, ladies and gentlemen, we do of course have our robot masters to deal with, and the first four robot masters we have available are Grenade Man, Frost Man, Tengu Man, and Clown Man. The order that I will be going through is probably an order that's mostly common. We're going to be going with Grenade Man as our first robot master, but if you want to see him, you're going to have to wait until the next episode because we are stopping here. That's right. That is a wrap on this episode of the Mega Man 8 playthrough. It's good to be back recording again. It's been a while since I've even started a new playthrough. Like I said, I've been going through some awkward moments in my personal life and with YouTube, been dealing with having to find a new partnership and just finding the drive and motivation to really start recording again. But it's good to be back. I hope you folks will stick with me for this playthrough because, as always, I hope to deliver a good, entertaining, and possibly informative playthrough of this game. The first Mega Man game I ever saw, really, so let's see what playthrough I can make out of it. Having said all that, that is going to do it for this episode. This is Punk Demon Neo signing out for now. If you folks enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. Be sure to share the video and subscribe if you'd like to see more, support the channel. And that's going to do it for this video. Punk Demon Neo here signing out, and I'll see you folks later.